Vulkan has arrived in Star Citizen with 323. How does it perform on AMD GPUs? In the last video, we had a look at general performance of Vulkan in 323 on a variety of CPUs and some GPUs. Signs were good, but my advice was to stick with DX11 in Star Citizen for now. But as a number of you noticed, there were no AMD GPUs featured in that testing. Partly that was down to time, but partly it was also down to the fact that I wanted to look at them separately. If you've been following this channel for a while, you'll be aware that I've been on a bit of a journey with AMD GPUs in Star Citizen. Over the last few years, I've done a number of different tests on mostly low-end cards, and a major problem kept going up. The cards with 4, 6, or even 8 gigabytes would suffer from these massive drops in performance. The exact cause is kind of difficult to pinpoint. It could be memory management, memory bandwidth, who really knows, but this problem was specific to AMD cards. Nvidia offerings with 6 or 8 gigabytes don't really seem to suffer. The only two AMD cards that I've tested without this issue were the 7900 XTX, which has got a massive 24 gigabytes of VRAM, and the 6700 XT, which has also got a pretty massive 12 gigabytes. So for a while, the recommendation on the AMD side was to get a card with plenty of memory. It's not really that tricky because AMD's lineup typically comes with loads of memory, more than the Nvidia alternatives. But one of the bonuses of a lower level graphics API like Vulkan is that it allows the game developer to have a much more active role in how GPU memory is sorted out. Unlike DX11, where the devs are kind of limited in what they can do, Vulkan allows them to get into the nitty-gritty and solve problems themselves. So has CIG solved this massive performance drop problem on lower end AMD cards? Well, it kind of looks like they have. We'll start with the 6700 XT as kind of a baseline. Remember, this card has got 12 gigabytes of VRAM. It doesn't suffer from these massive slowdowns. So let's use this to compare where DX11 and Vulkan are in comparison to each other. You'll see here, I've got an extra bit on the graph here. We've got the 95th percentile. And this basically shows us that DX11 has higher highs, but it also has lower lows. So you'll be able to see with the blue graph that the average FPS with DX11 is significantly higher than with Vulkan. And on this card, the 1% percentile stuff is roughly the same. But if we show you a frame time graph, you're gonna see there's actually quite a significant difference between these. Now, these graphs are a little bit tricky to understand, but the DX11 graph, the scale is from 0 to around 700 milliseconds. Whereas the Vulkan one is from 0 to around 140 milliseconds. So what you should be able to see is that with DX11, there's many, many more spikes where performance just falls to pieces. So loads of spikes around the 400 millisecond mark and above, some up to, 700 milliseconds. Performance is really, really choppy. But with Vulkan, it's much more smooth and steady. So although we don't hit the heights that we do with DX11 with Vulkan, we are getting smooth performance. This is quite similar to what we found when we tested the Nvidia cards. Basically, performance tends to be steadier. There's less spikes. It's all good. So that's our baseline with AMD cards. Now let's look at the 6600. This is a low-end card. It's only got 8 gigabytes of VRAM. And you'll see here that with DX11, there are some problems. We have these slowdowns. Now, if I show you this graph first, you'll see again that the highs are higher with DX11. The averages are not too far off actually in this case, but the 1% percentile FPS is lower with DX11. And again, in the frame time, this really becomes apparent. You'll see on the DX11 graph, again, we've got a scale of 0 to 900 milliseconds this time. And on the Vulkan one, 0 to 250 milliseconds. So there's still gonna be some spikes, even with Vulkan. This is Star Citizen after all, but again, the performance is significantly better in terms of steadiness and smoothness with Vulkan. You'll notice towards the end of this graph, this is all the runs put together that I did with this card. There's a big chunk here where DX11 has one of these massive slowdowns where it just falls to pieces and performance is awful for quite a while and then it recovers. And that's typically how it works. These cards from AMD with less VRAM, they have these drops where they go down to something like 5 FPS, stays there for a while, and then it recovers. It seems to be memory related anyway. But Vulkan is relatively smooth. What about the latest generation from AMD? So I've got a 7600 here. It's a faster card, again with 8 gigabytes, so a good thing to test in this case. In the runs I did with the 7600, there were more slowdowns. I don't think there's much to read into that compared to the 6600, but I think it seems to be fairly random when these slowdowns happen. At least I can't work out why they're happening when they are happening. But the DX11 result, the 1% percentile FPS is much lower. Average, therefore, is quite similar between them, or the blue graph. But again, DX11, the highs, the 95th percentile is much higher than with Vulkan. But again, the frame time. I've zoomed this one in so they're using the same scale. So it's 0 to 100 milliseconds. And so on the DX11 graph, those spikes, some of them go much, much higher, similar to the other cars we've just seen. But this gives you a real idea of the kind of all over the place nature of DX11 compared to Vulkan. Vulkan is steady as a rock. In some ways, if you're kind of a musical person, this is like a drummer who's just pretty steady. They play the beat. They don't mess around too much. They don't try anything too fancy, but they're steady. They're rock solid. They keep time. Whereas DX11 is like a crazy drummer, flashy all over the place, but time-wise, he's a bit manic. And so most musicians would prefer to play with a steady drummer. Vulkan, for gameplay right now, is much, much more usable on these cards. So whether CIG really went in and did this on purpose, whether they wanted to look at these lower end GPUs with less VRAM and try and fix things, or whether this is just a happy outcome of moving to Vulkan, I'm not really sure. But these lower end AMD cards are back on the menu. They are playable with Vulkan now. You are obviously losing overall average. The average is dropping down, but it's a much more playable experience. The spikes and these major drops in performance seem to be gone with Vulkan. Obviously, the 6700 XT also benefits from this, so it's not just the cars with less VRAM. I would be tempted for any AMD users to specifically try Vulkan out. And again, what's changed since the last video that I made was that we've now got 323.1, which all this testing was done on. And so Vulkan potentially had a few more fixes in whilst that was going. Potential memory leaks were fixed up. So it potentially looks like even NVIDIA users might be worth trying this out again. There are still issues around HDR, which I didn't mention last time, but a lot of people mentioned in the comments, HDR doesn't work. And also there's issues around the resolution and things like that, and playing in the native resolution of the monitor. It's a bit more fiddly, but it is still in development. It is still a beta. It's still at your own risk if you turn Vulkan on. But I think for AMD users, it's almost to the point where you'd probably be much better off playing with Vulkan versus DX11. That's what this testing at least is showing. So very good stuff from CIG. Thank you. Again, I don't know whether they did this on purpose, whether they did this, but this is an element of lower level APIs, is that they are going in, they have to, they can't just leave it to DX11 to do all the memory management and stuff. They have to manually, I think, my understanding is, they have to actually code and program and do all this stuff themselves. So great stuff. This is a really good sign, I think, for the game's stability and the frame judderiness that we've had for such long time with DX11. And as we said in the last video, the fact that this is only the first version of Vulkan and there's no multi-threaded rendering turned on in this, we've got to be excited for the next version. Hopefully that will come. Oh, could be a 323X patch, but possibly it will all come with 4.0.